welcome to Phuket News TV. This is the opening of Nikki Beach, and it's not just an occasion, this is an event. A fantastic night coming up, and we're going to be speaking to quite a few celebrities and some of the local celebrities as well. So stick around on Phuket News TV, we've got a lot coming up.
Nestled amongst the 20-kilometre golden sands of Natai Beach, a lean-to Phuket Pangar resort and spa for relaxing, romancing, or even a dream wedding in paradise. A lean-to Phuket Pangar resort and spa is your destination.
Welcome back to Phuket News TV, the opening of Nikki Beach, one of the biggest events we've had here on Phuket. Got a lot of people to talk to tonight, so let's get started. Jamie Jury, last time I saw you, you were moving rocks on some local TV station in Australia. What in earth are you doing here in Phuket?
Something like that, exactly. Well, you know, it's the opening of Nikki Beach. It's a huge event where guests of the Castlewood Group, and it's very exciting, actually. So, you know, there's a lot going on here in Phuket, and we want to be a part of it.
Do you get to Phuket often, or what's your interest in the area?
Well, we're currently filming our fourth episode of The Apartment, which we've been filming out of Kuala Lumpur for the last couple of years. But we're looking for new locations, so we're on the scout here in Phuket.
Now, when you started doing a landscaping show in Australia, I don't know what, 12, 15 years ago?
Exactly 15 years ago this year, actually.
Did you ever think you'd be where you are now? So, celebrity gardener.
You know, to me, it all feels like it all happened in about 10 minutes. And yeah, it's been amazing. I mean, it's taken me all around the world, and I've been lucky enough to work with people like Oprah and all sorts of amazing people. So, yeah, I wouldn't change a thing. I just love it.
Now, Nikki Beach, have you been to any other openings at the other locations around the world?
Of course. I've been to Miami. I've been to them all. And I'm a huge fan of the brand. I think it's going to be perfect for this location. And from a design perspective, I think the team at Castlewood are going to do a very nice job.
Jamie Jury, thank you very much.
My pleasure. See you soon.
Cause all we got is right now. Tomorrow way too far away. Oh. Could we get back yesterday? But we young right now. We got it right now.
Now, the people you meet here at Nikki Beach, Dom Lau.
What's going on? It's very nice to be here and lovely to see you again, Zimmy. How's things?
Fantastic, and it's really good to have you back in Phuket. How's the show going?
The show is going superbly well. In fact, ratings went up after we broadcast from the station at 89.5, so thank you very much for that. But I'd tell you, I came down last time, paradise on earth right here, and any reason to come back is a good one, and the reason today is, of course, Nikki Beach.
Now, do you have any affiliation with Nikki Beach? Have you been to any of the other openings around the world?
I have not been to any of the openings, but I have visited Nikki Beach. I've been to Bali, and of course paid a visit there. Absolutely fantastic. Those guys, they know how to throw a party. So when I got the call, invited myself down here to Nikki Beach.
Invited yourself.
Sorry, I did. I'm gate crashing. Yeah. No, but when I got the call to come down, couldn't pass it up.
What is special about Nikki Beach?
Well, I'll tell you, anywhere you go in the world, when you go on holiday, evidently some people like to relax, other people like to party, right? Two opposite ends of the spectrum. And with Nikki Beach, you get the best of both. And the cool thing about Nikki Beach is everyone is everybody else's friend. You know, it's a bit like Cheers in that way, where everyone knows your name. You go down, you are guaranteed 100% to have a fantastic time, make new friends, and as a result, want to come back for more.
Yeah. Now, what else is on your plate at the moment? Any projects coming up?
Yes. I'm still.
What you can tell us about?
Well, I can't tell you about all of them. Some very exciting things happening in middle 2014. I'll be traveling down to Australia, actually. I'm going to be doing a new travel program. I can't tell you the name yet, but first stop is Australia, and it's going to be very, very exciting. It's got a little bit of a twist to it as well. We're doing the Prince and Pauper travel experience. So there'll be myself and a co-host, who's a dear friend of mine, Paula.
Did you get the prince job or the pauper job?
Well, we're going to flip a coin. We're going to flip a coin at each checkpoint, right? So we flip a coin, one person lives the high life, the other one has to live like a pauper.
it sounds like a fantastic idea. I think I'll watch that.
It'll be fantastic, and I hope hopefully we'll be able to do that, do one of those episodes in Phuket, because it'll be fantastic to come back. As I say, I don't mean to keep on milking it, but what a fantastic place to come to. Phuket, love it.
And we love listening to Asia Pop 40 each week. Dom Lau, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Enjoy the party.
It's my great pleasure to introduce to you the Global Communications Director for Nikki Beach Worldwide, Julie Vogel. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me. Thank you for coming here.
Yeah.
We're
now,
so excited.
The elephant's close by there, so be careful.
Yes.
There's a lovely backstory to the Nikki Beach clubs around the world. Just share that with us.
So Nikki Beach was started by Jack Penrod in 1998. It was started as a celebration of his daughter Nicole's life. So all of our Nikki Beaches around the world are really a celebration of life and about beautiful things and bringing all the things that Nicole loved, fashion, dining, entertainment, music, film and art into one. And that's the concept behind Nikki Beach. And so when Jack opened the first one in 1998 in Miami, he wasn't going to expand, but it was the magic of the customers, a young Leonardo DiCaprio, a young Sean Penn, everybody, Madonna, were just showing up, and it created this demand. So they expanded in Saint-Tropez, and then they went to St. Bart, Marbella, Spain. Now we have three locations in Spain: Marrakesh, Morocco, Saint-Tropez.
Get it right.
Everywhere. Oh, I can. Should we go with all 10? Let's do it.
Yeah.
Miami, Saint-Tropez, St. Bart, Marbella, Cabo, Marrakesh, Morocco, Koh Samui, Thailand, Mallorca, Spain, Ibiza, Spain, and Phuket.
A round of applause. Well done. What's the significance about Phuket in the Nikki Beach framework?
We expanded to Southeast Asia and Thailand and Koh Samui in 2009, and it was wonderful. And the people, the location, the beach, it's everything for Nikki. The energy, it's great. And so it worked well in Koh Samui, and it was a demand for it here, and you can't really beat this location. The sunset is just amazing. So yeah, it's perfect. I know Jack loves it. He was here 2 weeks ago and he just had the most amazing time.
Who goes to Nikki Beach?
Jet setters of the world. People that want to have something to celebrate, whether it's getting a new job or a birth in their family. It's a nice, because it's family owned and operated, it's a nice family ambience, but it's people that want to have fun. So I'll never forget when Jack's wife, Lucia, who's actually my boss, she sent me a photo from St. Bart, and it was a photo of a young couple with their kids and their friends, and they were on the beach drinking rosé wine, having sushi, and dancing to the music, and their kids were in the sand next to them, and they go, this is what it's all about. And it's about being with people you love, having a good time, and just being happy.
Now, Phuket has about 23 beach clubs. I would have said that if you were going to have a business model for a successful business, I wondered if I'd start a new beach club. So what makes Nikki Beach special?
Nikki Beach was the first beach club in 1998. It was interesting because we went to Ibiza last summer. Everybody's like, well, what are you doing in Ibiza? You know, I'm like, well, actually, we started out somewhere. We came to Ibiza, and actually all the beach clubs in Ibiza started after 1998. So it's what makes us different is that we are the original. The beach club, someone once told Jack, and Jack will always say, he doesn't know if this is true or not, that he changed the way that people have a good time and party, because it was shifted from a nighttime to a daytime, because that's the way that him and his family enjoy to spend their time during the daytime. So that's really how it started. So we're original. We love everybody. We get along with everybody, and we're just happy to be here and joining a nice group of beach clubs.
Tell us about the white.
This actually started, it's an interesting story, in 2001 in Saint-Tropez, Naomi Campbell's having her birthday party at Nikki Beach, and they were thinking about a unique thing to go about it. And we were like, why doesn't everybody just dress in all white? Because Nikki Beach is very white beach beds, white decor, and that's how it started, from Naomi Campbell's birthday in Saint-Tropez.
But Naomi Campbell looks a lot better in white than I do.
I think you look great.
Bless you.
I think you look amazing. I mean,
You're saying all the right things.
Amazing.
Yeah. Julie, congratulations on the opening. Our best wishes. And thank you very much for coming to Phuket.
Thank you. Thanks for having us here.
Julie Vogel. It's a great pleasure to welcome the special guest here to Nikki Beach tonight, Kellen Lutz. Welcome to Phuket.
Thanks for having me.
And a week ago, you were walking the red carpet at the Oscars.
Yeah, that was a busy week of Oscar fun, which I've never been to the Oscars. So working with Red Carpet Green Dress with Susie Amos Cameron and James Cameron for the charity. Olga and I wore a sustainable wardrobe. So my tux was made out of 55% recycled plastic bottles, 45% silk. My pants were made out of hemp. So it was really, really great and very educational to learn that you can actually wear stuff that lasts.
Were they comfortable?
It was extremely comfortable. You wouldn't even know the difference.
I suppose the only issue with things like that is the cost of, you know, making them for the wider community.
They're sustainable, so if you look long run, they'll last forever compared to some of the fashion obsolescence that actually destroys the fabrications and the materials, so you have to keep on coming back and getting new clothes.
Now, did you get into Ellen's selfie?
No.
You missed out.
Yeah, I missed out on that.
Let's have a talk about some of your charity work, because sure. I was really impressed reading about it, some of the work you do in L.A.
There's a lot. Any in particular? I'll just go into, well, Peter, you know, being here in Thailand, Phuket for the first time, it's a dream of mine, and I can't believe it's off the bucket list, thanks to John Lewis and Julie, and Mike Pinrod, and Jack, having them come, for me to come down here for Nikki Beach, which I'm a huge fan of the brand that they've created. But for my charity work back in L.A. and around the world, working with PETA, there's, what I was getting at before the tangent, was there's stray cats and dogs here. So it's kind of one of those things where it's like, stop the car, let's get out, let's buy some food. And so I work with PETA, ASPCA, so that's with rescuing animals. Saving Innocence, which is one near and dear to my heart, about rescuing victims of sex trafficking.
Now, I was really interested in that. Is this a big issue in places like LA?
It is, surprisingly. I've worked with Unlikely Heroes over in Cambodia, but to learn that it's happening in my own backyard, and that's where I act, that's where my family is, that's where my friends are, is really eye-opening to learn the statistics. Girls are being trafficked at an average age of 12, so that's young, and I have a sister, so that just kind of hits me in the wrong way. And just being a part of that organization and making a difference and seeing it actually take place in my home is a big difference.
In LA, of all places.
Yeah.
Now, I saw a photo of you just about half an hour ago of you feeding a stray cat.
Yeah, that's what I was getting at. Yeah, we found we're at the gym. We found a gym, went to the gym. Surprisingly, we're on vacation. My buddies and I went to the gym at 6:30 this morning, and we saw this little kitten just prancing around, playing on this yellow wire. And we went over there afterwards, and he was extremely skinny. And you could just tell he was looking for some nutrition. So went into the 7-Eleven, found some tuna, opened that up, and he became my best friend. So it was, I call him Nittany Lion, because I love Penn State, and he's just he's a special one, and he looked really hungry, and he devoured it.
We've got the Soy Dog Foundation, the Street Dog Foundation here in Phuket.
What's that
and
about?
Street dogs, well, there's a lot of, around Thailand, just street dogs, stray dogs.
Yeah.
And because the Thais are mostly Buddhist, they don't believe in neutering the animals, letting nature take its course. But, of course, that causes problems when the dogs breed and the cats breed too. And the Soy Dog Foundation have got into a program of capturing, neutering, rehabilitating, and then releasing. So over time, the number of stray dogs in the area, and so it's better for the dogs and better for the humans.
That's amazing.
Yeah, we should get you down there while you're here.
Yeah, I would love to.
Great organization.
Is it close to Phuket?
It's in Phuket. Just
Now, is it a facility that they actually house dogs and they?
Yeah. So some of the older dogs that aren't going to find a home, they look after. They've got about 250 dogs there, and they look after them really, really well.
That's amazing. Good on them.
I'm going to make sure you're introduced to them.
I would love to.
Let's do it. Come out with me.
Let's talk about your next movie, because what are you up to at the moment?
I hear Jean-Claude Van Damme's here. I finished Expendables 3, which comes out I think July 15th or August 15th. So working on the press with that, we're going to go to Cannes and do a big release with that one. Hercules just came out. I think it's out on this side of the world right now.
And you do your own stunts, I hear.
I do as many as I can. That's the best part of the job. I love doing stunt work. I love doing action movies, blowing stuff up, shooting guns, really pushing myself to the limits. I love doing mixed martial arts as well. It's just, it's a passion of mine.
I've taken up far too much of your time. Thank you very much for coming to Phuket. Lovely to meet you.
Hey, thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Kellen Lutz.
Amazing party, amazing place. Good vibe. What can we say, yeah?
Well, I hope you've enjoyed the night as much as I have here at Nikki Beach. The opening of this really significant brand, another addition to the Beach Club family here in Phuket. There's a lot of them, but this one's really special. Hope you've enjoyed yourself here on Phuket News TV tonight. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, girl. I'm feeling so
Mumbai, Bollywood, Hollywood, it's all about the money, cash.